So when Nancy's father heard the story, he said that the...
Where were you?
He said, you didn't get angry. I said, no, I thought it was kind of funny. Then he said, well, I think I'd better tell you something about my daughter and corrections. He said, in Chicago, where she lived most of her life, he said, I tried to get her to deliver something for me to an office down on State Street. So he said, and he finally desperately, he said, look,
not this true.
For Marshall Fields, he said, I found out that she could find her way.
Yes, I was dressed for it.
If you started with where it was in relation to Marshall Fields.
Bravo, you wave a little bit and you kind of look a little bit to the side and you just have a very daring sort of expression. So I could say that the speech is over.
You don't want me looking at the lens this time.
Yes, I would. Yes. Good. Oh, terrific. Thank you, sir. Oh, there's my picture.
If she's through, how she keep on talking?
I never
stop.
President, did you notice Mark's speech today? He thought he was going to somewhere.
So did I.
Yeah, well, you tell your friend the speaker, he's on my list.
Yes. We were supposed to be on our way to the ranch.
I was coming with you, but I'm looking forward to it tomorrow.
These two. Yeah. It's a big disappointment.
Well, I'll get hold of you 24 hours, one way or another.
Yes. I'll settle for 12 if he'll let me tell him what he should do in those 12.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Pleasure.
It really isn't bad luck.
Good to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
It's always a pleasure.
Come on in.
Thank you, sir.
Take a minute now. With the aid to the democracies down there, they have four other countries, which is certainly in keeping with the Kissinger report that we got from early on as to what should be our best approach to all of Central America. I'm really sold that that's the way to go, and particularly since none of the money is new money. All that money is appropriated and unused, and some in aid, some in State Department. From that time, the military is for the defense budget. There's John.
Yes, sir.
But I understand, Robert, well, see you.
Hi,
it's good to see you, sir.
Well, there's probably a mixed emotion on the hill about the situation. But,
well, anyway, I feel very strongly that the whole time element and everything else militates against the present amendment that is in the construction bill and the amendment that is being offered by Skelton, Edwards, and all of them. Simply on the time element alone and the certainty of it that if passed, where the murder thing still leaves it out there that the Contras are going to have to go for months wondering whether they're going to get the money because of that second vote that would be required. The time is of the essence with them. They're hurting for ammunition and so forth, what they need. And we just believe that the whole development that's taking place now, the four other democratic nations now, Honduras, Costa Rica, El Salvador, and Guatemala, we've heard from almost all four of the heads of those governments are solidly behind us.
Hi, Mr. President.
Hi. I have my volume tuned up too high here.
Is it adjusted?
Yes. It squeals when it's...
I can hear it.
It's still squealing.
That must be an uncomfortable feeling, too.
Well, it's just
squealing that close to the ear.
Oh, wait a minute. I, that's why I did it. I just turned it the wrong way before. There we are. All right, well, come in. Take a chair.
Here. Thank you.
I tell you, these are the most wonderful and remarkable things. What I have is one bad ear from a gunshot that was didn't hit me. It was in a picture some years ago, and the fellow put the gun right up on my ear and fired it. Damn, it knocked my head off with the concussion. And over the years, where the nerves deteriorated. So I knew I had one ear that wasn't doing right by me. And I got, this is a brand new type of thing. And then the doctor talked me into balancing it. The other ear's all right, this ear here, but he talked me into balancing it up. But that's all there is. That's the total,
the whole,
the hearing aid. No more wires and panels or anything like that. Just that little.
And obviously, you can hear quite well, except for the squeals.
Yeah. And as I say, it lets you know when it's Well, I know we've talked before and talked about the submarine bases and so forth down there, but I think we're down to now really you might say almost last chance. And I just wanted to talk to you about that. Edwards and Ray and Skelton and Chandler. Amendment that you're going to be voting on today. I think that this is the way to go. It provides over a period of time installments in military aid and some humanitarian aid to the countries. And then a great feature that carries out the purposes of the Kissinger Commission we appointed quite some time ago in all of Central America, $300 million in economic aid to those four